pecans, pineapple, and banana.
There's been really nice desserts this week, but ours is better.
Yeah, this one pulls out all the stops.
Once baked, they'll top with cream cheese frosting. And look, they've even made a gluten-free version for Victoria. How thoughtful. So, after a quick change...
Underlay, underlay.
Arriva.
Our duo are ready to greet their guests. And first into the battleground, its current leaders, Victoria and Delroy.
Hi, guys. Good to see you again. Come on in, Del.
Hi, bring it in. Come on. There we go. Lovely.
So, are you panicked and nervous because you know you've got to beat us?
Oh, the gloves come off so early in the night.
Making up the numbers and embracing the Mexican theme, it's Pam and Joker Glenn.
Guys, great to see you again.
Hi, oh, look.
You guys look fantastic.
It's a false hand. Genius.
The one I feel sorry for is Pam. I mean, it can't be easy living with Glenn, can it? Poor woman. I really feel
she must be exhausted.
Yeah.
Coming up, hidden extras.
Sorry, there's a hair in mine.
I'm so sorry.
Definitely not something that you'd expect at a dinner party. It puts you right off.
And the winners are revealed.
Second place.
It's the final night in Northampton, and Wendy and Mark's turn to bid for the grand. So while the hosts get their Mexican menu underway, Joker Glenn has a captive audience.
I got it from a second-hand shop.
No way.
Boom.
Meanwhile, upstairs, Victoria and Pam have uncovered photographer Wendy's collection of strange props.
Whoa.
It was a bit sinister.
That's what I sound like in bed.
Oh, wow.
Good stuff. Got to hand it to him. Got for laughing, you?
Don't worry, Del. The girls will be back down in a minute.
Wow. And who is this? I think this is Wendy. It looks like her in a lot of these shots. I mean, that's clearly her.
Oh, that's harsh.
No.
Yeah. This is extremely weird.
Off the scale.
Back in the kitchen, Mark tops the starters with avocado, and it's ready to serve.
You know what? I'm really happy with this. It's colourful, it's tasty. They're going to love it.
Here we go. Ding, ding. Into battle, round one.
It's Ariba Ariba prawn cocktail. Hope those crackers are gluten-free. I'm sure they are.
They serve it with crackers, but it's a savoury cracker.
Are they gluten-free?
Oh, my God, you can't eat these. I'm sure.
That's okay.
Yes, I know, I feel terrible.
That's okay.
I've worked so hard to make sure that you had gluten-free things tonight, and I forgot and gave you crackers.
Yeah, no problem. I was gutted that they didn't have a cracker for me and that they'd actually forgotten the fact that I needed a gluten-free cracker. And poor Wendy's face was absolutely mortified.
Whoops. Oh, I'm sorry.
I was really hoping that tonight would be completely
She's going to hold it
flawless
against us.
For...
She knows we're the competition. So she's got an opportunity to take us down a bit there. Fantastic flavours, fresh prawns, love avocado. It was great.
I enjoyed the flavours. It was uncomplicated, but, I like uncomplicated.
I really hope you enjoyed the starter. We are going to take our leave and go sort out the next course.
Thank you.
Lovely.
Chat amongst yourselves. This is one small mistake. There won't be any more, though. This is it. Everything else is going to be completely flawless through the rest of the evening.
Good. On with the main, and at least you don't have to worry about gluten in the rice.
Is that gluten-free?
Okay, we need to have a look at this, I think.
Yeah, I think you do, because I don't want to give her anything else that she can't have.
Yes, food made from grains and grain-like plants that do not contain harmful gluten. Plain rice in all its forms, white, brown, wild, basmati.
So, you know, yay for that.
Yay! Next, Wendy pulls her pork, drizzles with orange juice and cumin, and then pops into corn tortillas.
So I married a domestic goddess, didn't I?
Yes, and I have married a domestic god.
With the chicken sliced and the veggies sizzling, it's ready.
and I think everybody is really going to enjoy it. I think we have a winner here.
Chicken fajitas and pork carnitas, and it's gluten-free, so there's nothing for Victoria to complain about.
I'm really sorry, there's a hair in mine.
Don't.
I'm so sorry.
Yes.
Yeah. Sorry. Yeah, that would be mine. Nope.
Have you washed your hair?
Yes.
Okay, it's all right then.
Yeah, I told you to shower this morning.
We gave her some crackers, which she couldn't eat, and then we put her hair in her food.
She was so gracious about it. She really was. I took such care today, and it floated away from me.
Yes, hair does that.
Definitely not something that you'd expect at a dinner party. It puts you right off.
Enjoying that tortilla, Pam?
Can I ask you, Pam? I caught a little glance between you and Glenn there, and there's some big wide eyes going on.
Was there?
Yes, there was.
We love each other.
Yeah. Is that all it was about, or was it about the food?
Awkward. Still awkward. Still awkward.
The tortillas for me are a little bit heavy. I'm not good with a lot of bread, so I'm finding it a little bit heavy going. Maybe I've just had too much wonderful food the last few days.
<I can't believe
laughs>
I think she held back on her comments. I think she wanted to say more, but she's really polite, so she's not going to say more at the table.
The flour tortillas, I didn't like, and the pork, I didn't like. It was dry, and I didn't like the corn.
Pork, I mean, I didn't really think that much of it, and it was actually quite dry as well.
Yeah, the pork was definitely dead.
Dead. Uh-oh.
Victoria and I had a little wander around the house.
Oh, yeah.
And we found a room.
There is nothing I like better than to pop on a gas mask and a bloody wedding dress and have someone snap my picture. It's my favorite thing in the world. I mean, I do. I just really, really love it.
To me, I just think this is all a bit weird, really. But, you know, if it floats your boat, then, yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
When Del was listening, you could see his face was a bit sort of... He was wide-eyed and I haven't got a clue what's going on here.
Does anybody else want to have a go at, like, a horror face?
You all right with this, Del?
Don't think he knew what to say. No. Didn't know or what to think. So he just tried to melt.
Yeah. Wow, that pork really was dry.
I was ready to jump out and, smash the window and just, yeah.
Well, I was a bit worried in case you just leant over and clocked someone in the face.
Time to serve the last course of the week, I think.
Oh, you're doing such a good job. It's better than me.
Really looking forward to it. It's a great dessert. I think everybody's really going to love it. It's the one that's going to take us home.
You are home. It's hummingbird cake and a gluten-free sponge for Victoria. Time for a spot of synchronized sniffing.
No hummingbirds were harmed in the making of this cake, just so you know.
Absolutely delightful. Really love the moistness of it. I don't really make cakes, but I enjoy eating them.
Cake is nice, but cake is cake. That's what I think. It was just a cake.
That's so profound.
It was moist, it was tasty, had great texture. The hummingbird cake was a revelation.
To top off our Mexican evening, I have a very special guest that I would like to bring in for you to meet tonight. And while I'm doing it, I've got a little gift for you I'd like you to pop on.
Kenny.
Would you take any of these?
I'll take whichever one you think suits me best. Thank you.
Could you do like a small chic mustache? Everybody, it is my favorite Mexican, Mark's favorite person. It's Pippin.
Hello, Pippin.
Here is to the end of a great Mexican night. Inspired, of course, by Pippin.
Yes.
Is anyone else terrified by this?
I think we've won it. I think it's in the bag.
Sadly, not your bag, though.
I will be absolutely gutted if we don't win. I think we put more effort in than anyone, and I think we deserve to win, definitely.
I actually feel very optimistic, you know? I'm feeling pretty confident right now. I think we might have just clinched it, baby.
Well, to do that, you'll need 32 to snatch the prize from Victoria and Delroy.
Been a really nice meal tonight. There's been some really good elements, a couple of disappointments, a couple of faux pas. But all in all, we think we should give Wendy and Mark 16!
Tonight was really fun. We had a great laugh and we enjoyed the company, but the food was a bit hit and miss. So tonight, we're giving Wendy and Mark...
Hold your horses! Your hosts will reveal the results.
Yay!
place is Glenn and Pam. Second place is Wendy and Mark. Which means in first place, Delroy and Victoria.
Victoria and Delroy scored Wendy and Mark 13.
I'm so disappointed. But lovely couple, and they deserve to win. I'm really happy for them.
Yeah, same.
For more on couples, come down with me. Head to the Channel 4 website.
Think, babe. You've done so well over the course of this competition, I might not even do the angry face at you.
Cool, that's great.
I'll try anyway. I don't know how long it'll last, but I'll try.
Lovely.
Did we win? No, we didn't win, Pippin. Whose fault is that?
It's my fault. I was not a very good mascot for you.